pass this time as well. So, number one, obviously, make sure you close your hands. When you do close them, don't roll these bits up too tight, because these knuckles here, I don't know if you can see, when you push, see there's a bit of movement there, and you know you can damage these parts of your knuckles. So press them into the middle of your hand, so actually press them in. So now that's not going to go anywhere, okay? You don't want to roll them up right up tight, and then see there's a gap there underneath where your fingernails are, and then these fingers have got a bit of movement, so you can hurt yourself. So just let them down a bit, close your hand in tight, you know, so nice and square at the end, okay? So you're punching these two knuckles. First thing we're going to do is the connection. Sometimes you see people, especially if they're worried, I mean, obviously hitting a bag, red knuckle, sometimes it hurts, people scrape themselves and it, you know, it does damage. So they're a little bit nervous. But you see people also, they swing quite hard, but there's not much at the end because they're not actually connected. They've got a lot of power leading up to the target, but when they actually hit the target, the power might be going off in different directions, just not actually hitting the target clean. So what we're going to do first, you're going to obviously close your hand up nice and tight, but on the way there, it's going to be loose, okay? Not tensing up like this. No speed, you know, no, basically there's not going to be any power in, you're going to be too stiff, you're going to be cutting your body off. So on the way there, you're going to relax, and then you're going to snap your hand at the end, so it's nice and tight, so it's solid, okay? You're just going to just tap the bag, okay? So even just tapping it, you can see, you know, you're just digging your knuckles in, so it's got some sort of effect, okay? I'm going to do it at the bottom of the bag first, because this is a little bit more solid at the bottom, okay? Obviously, all the weight's down here, so we're just going to get used to it in the bag on the solid bit. So you're just going to flick your hand first of all, and you're just going to almost bounce your hand off the bag, almost like it's a ball. If you're throwing a ball at the wall and you wanted it back, you wouldn't just throw the ball to the wall, because it just hit and drop. You want to throw it through the wall and it'll bounce back. That's what you want to do with your hand. So I'm going to push it through a little bit, just like that, just nice and easy. Just pull it up a little bit and just get used to it. And then basically the faster you pull that back from the bag, the harder it's going to be. Okay, so that's your first one. So keep your wrist straight, knuckles in line with your forearm, okay, so that way, not like this. Obviously don't bend your wrist either way, okay, so nice and solid, okay, relax, and then when you get to the target, you're just going to bounce your hand back off the target as well, okay, so not just going to push it, you're going to hit and pull it back. Every time you hit the bag, you want it to dent as well, so you want it just to dent first and then move, okay? So you don't want it just the bag flying all over the place, but there's no, you know, dent in the bag, because if you're hitting the first, and that just means you just push them. You want obviously the power to go into the target, okay? So we're just going to do a jab to the body now, okay? So I'm just going to push it out, you're just going to get that connection, and you're just going to push just through the bag, just nice and easy, and just pull it back. So don't try and hit it too hard first of all. You want to build up your rhythm and your technique first of all, so just nice and light, and just push. Sometimes when the bag comes towards you as well, it's going to be a little bit heavier because obviously it's got momentum. So sometimes just try and just push and just stop the bag as it comes. So just mix it up a bit, just push through the bag, okay? Just with the other hand, so it's nice and easy, just push them through, okay? You can double it up if you want. Okay, so that's the first bit. So you're getting, just building your confidence to get through the bag. The faster you throw it, the harder it'll be. So if your first one, you just do it nice and light, then you do exactly the same, a little bit faster, and a little bit more through the bag, and then you just build it up and build it up, and it gets stronger and have a lot more impact. Okay? So that's the first bit. Now we're just going to look at a hook as well. Okay? We're just going to do this from standing, first of all. So you're not going to go like this, and then somebody headbutts you or hits you first. You're just going to come straight at the target, so you're going to turn your hips first of all. Then it's like from here, it's almost like you left your arm behind. Okay, so when you're going to swing around like this, your arm will start moving, and then at the end you're going to get this lock at the end. Okay, so your body goes first, and then you get a lock. Okay? I don't know if you can see that sort of movement. Okay, so body first, the other hand comes up as well. So as you're hitting the target, obviously you've got something to follow back with, and you've got a guard. And the same principle as before, don't just hit and leave it there, you're going to hit, bring it back as well, so we'll start off nice and light, so turn your body, get that lock, bang, and just get it to bring it back as well, and the other hand, as you do it, just get used to bringing the other hand up slightly, okay, so as you go round this way, the other hand comes up. Natural body movement as well, so rather than just keeping this down and not using this side of the body, it's just a bit more of a rhythm to your technique. Okay, so you're going to swing through, get that lock as well. Don't swing the arm with the body, it's just like throwing a ball. If you had a ball in your hand, you wouldn't throw your arm and your hip at the same time. You'd whip it, your hips would go first, and then it comes through, so gradually you're coordinating everything. Okay, so it wouldn't just happen all at the same time, it's the same with the punch. So your body goes first, so using everything from your feet, a little bit of bend from the legs, and then as you're hitting the target, you've got this coming through as well, so you've got that whip, so you're hitting through. Okay? And obviously close your hand, make sure it's nice and straight at the end. When you're hitting the target, make sure your forearms in line. A lot of people bend their wrist, I don't know why, they seem to think because they're punching round, they tend to bend their wrist up like this. So make sure it's nice and straight, just the same as you're doing a straight punch, just coming round so it's solid at the end. Okay? And then just the more confident you get, you know you're not going to hurt yourself, so it's with the knuckles, your wrist will strengthen up a bit. So you can swing round, and then maybe just throw a couple of combinations, go back to the first one. You can aim high as well, like I said at the beginning, I'm only aiming low, just because that's the heart of it, obviously, if you want to punch up towards someone's head, you can, okay? So you can aim high, and just mix those combinations up just slightly. Don't try and swing too hard at the target, so it's all nice and quick, nice and light, and everything you're hitting with has a bit of power behind it. So, I mean, if you can dent a bag like this, I mean, obviously if you're punching someone with your knuckles in the face, you're going to hurt them, okay? So, that's that.